Hey guys, what's up? My name is Ayush Khanna and you are watching our channel Ayush Khanna Classes. In this lecture, I'm going to explain you a costings topic, that is standard costing. Okay, that is standard costing. Now this lecture is applicable for the CA IPCC old course, CA intermediate new course, and CMA and CMA intermediate for the cost accounting subject. Okay, now let's start. Standard costing. In this lecture, while teaching standard costing, I'll just try to make you memorize the formulas and how to solve the sum. Okay, I'll just help you to memorize the formulas, because this topic, standard costing, even to CA final students don't understand it properly. Okay, even CA final students don't understand this topic very easily. Okay, now let's start. Basic formulas. Firstly is of our material cost variance. So it is of material variances. First is of material variances. Material variances. Under this, the first formula is of material cost variance. What would be the material cost variance? It would be standard cost minus actual cost. Material cost variance, it is cost variance. So we will take the total cost, that is standard cost minus actual cost, that is a standard quantity for actual output, into standard price minus actual quantity into actual rate or actual price. Okay, under these two, under this material cost variances, it is classified further into two types, two variances, that is material price variance and material usage variance. Now, what is the formula of material price variance? As the word there is price, so it would be standard price minus actual price into actual quantity. Standard price minus actual price into actual quantity. Wherever the price comes, the word price comes, we will subtract the standard price and actual price. Okay. Material usage variance, or the material quantity variance, you can say. Quantity variance, what the formula is? The word quantity is there, so it would be standard quantity minus actual quantity into standard price. Okay, standard quantity minus actual quantity into standard price. Now, one small way to check whether the answer is correct or not. There is a formula called DMCV equals to DMPV plus DMQV. Okay. What's this? DMCV, direct material cost variance. DMPV, direct material price variance, plus direct material quantity variance. Now what are direct material? These only same: material cost variance, material price variance, and material quantity variance. Now usage or quantity variance is further classified into two types. The first is direct material mix variance. डायरेक्ट मटेरियल मिक्स वेरियंस. What is it? What's the formula for direct material mix variance? It is revised standard quantity minus actual quantity into standard price. Revised standard quantity minus actual quantity into standard price. Okay, and what is DMYV? It is direct material yield. Direct material yield variance. It is standard quantity minus actual quantity minus revised standard quantity into standard price. Standard quantity minus RSQ, that is revised standard quantity into standard price. Have you noted a thing that in every case standard quantity comes first? Standard quantity comes first. And actual quantity comes at second after minus. Have you just noticed? So these are some small ways to remember these formulas. Okay, now second one is labor variances. It's same as material variances, like labor cost variance. Labor cost variance, it would be standard cost minus actual cost, that is standard hours into standard rate minus actual hours which are paid for. Okay, actual hours paid for into actual rate. Standard hours into standard rate minus actual hours paid for into actual rate. Okay, I hope you got it. Now, let's start with yet another variances. That is variable overhead variance. Variable overhead variance. Variable overhead cost variance equals to standard variable overhead for production minus actual variable overhead. Minus actual variable overhead. What that means? Expected variable overhead, which were estimated at the time of production or before the production, minus actual variable overhead which were incurred after the production. Okay, now under this there are two classifications, that is variable overhead expenditure or spending variance. In the question paper, in the exams, it can be asked as variable overhead expenditure variance or variable overhead spending variance. The formula is again standard rate minus actual rate. Why? Because it is expenditure incurred. Standard rate minus actual rate into actual hours worked. Now there is a difference between actual hours paid for and actual hours worked. Please make sure you differentiate in the question between the two. Okay, now next is variable overhead efficiency variance. Now efficiency means number of hours worked, time worked. The formula would be standard hours minus actual hours into what? Into standard rate. Okay, into standard rate. I hope you got it. Now let's start with the sums. Only our two variances, only our two variances are left, that is fixed overhead variances and sales variances, sorry. Okay, now let's start with question. Now from where to solve the questions? The only relevant book for the subject of costing is your practice manual and study material only. Okay, only practice manual and study material. Because if you do any author's book, any tuition teacher's book, then you will 110% confused. You'll be confused. Okay. Now let's start with our very first question. That is question number 2 of practice manual of old course. Whether you are new course or old course, you have to refer both. You both have to refer practice manual as well as study material only. Okay, practice manual and study material. I'll just open here. Students corner. Knowledge portal, IPC, cost accounting paper number 3 and financial management, practice manual relevant for May 2016 examination onwards. Then in this I think 11, chapter number 11 would be there. Chapter number 11 of cost accounting. This is here we get. There's some problem here, so don't worry. You can download it. You can download it from your phone. In your phone, it would be easily downloaded. Now let's start with question number 2. The efficiency ratio, capacity ratio, you can see these formulas as you can solve the very simple ones. Okay, now let's start. KPR Limited operates a system of standard costing. These type of things are given. Direct material 5 kg at 4.20, direct labor 3 hours at rupees 3, factory overheads rupees 1.20 per labor hour, and total manufacturing cost is 33.60. Okay, now the production schedule for the month of June 13 required completion of 40,000 units. However, 40,960 were completed during the month without opening and closing WIP. Okay, purchases made during the month of June 13th was 225,000 of material at the rate of 4.50 per kg. Purchases made were how much? 225,000 kgs. Okay. Next, production sales account, these things, material used. Now here, material used 205,600, that is material consumed, actual, you can say actual what, actual quantity, direct labor, 1 to 1 2 00 hours, 1 to 1 2 00 hours. It is the actual hours worked. Then total factory overhead cost incurred 1 lakh and sales was ₹40,000. Okay. Selling price to be fixed as to the as to allow a markup of 20% on selling price. Okay. Required calculate material variances based on consumption of material, labor variances and total variances for factory overheads. Okay, now let's start with the question. Question number 2 of practice manual, old course, page number 11.12. Now let's start. Material variances. Material variances. See, the very first is direct material cost variance. Direct material cost variance. Its formula is standard cost minus actual cost. As you know, 40,960 kgs we would take and not the budgeted ones, okay, which was required. We would just ignore that, which we have completed. We would take that amount which we have completed minus actual cost. What is the actual cost incurred? 2,05,600 kg. Sorry, just a second mistake here. It is units, okay, into 5 kg into 4.20 minus actual cost. What is the actual cost incurred? 2,05,600 kgs into, what's the rate? 4.50. Okay. 4.50. The amount would be 65,040. Adverse. You have to write this adverse. In case the amount is negative, then we would write adverse, that is A. If the amount is positive, then we would write F, that is favorable. Then DMPY. Sorry, DMPV. It is actual quantity into what? Standard price minus actual price. It's 2,05,600 kgs actual quantity into standard price 4.20 minus 4.30. That means it's 30% of 2,05,600. That comes out to be 61,680. Again, adverse. DM QV. It is standard quantity minus actual quantity into standard price. Standard quantity, how much? 40,960 into 5 kgs -2,05,600 kgs. Into standard price. What is the standard price? Rupees 4.20. Okay, I hope you got it. The answer is 3,360 adverse. Now you can check the answer, or you can verify DMCV equals to DMPV plus DMQV DMCV 65040 adverse equals to 61680 adverse plus 3,360 adverse. The answer is verified. Okay, now in the same way you can solve second part, that is labor variances. And one more, they have asked total variances. Now what would be the formula of total variances? Total variances. Total factory variances. It would be factory overhead absorbed minus actual factory overhead minus actual factory overhead. That would be actual hours into standard rate minus actual factory overhead. It would be 40,960 into 3 hours into 3 hours into 1.20 into 1.20 minus 1 lakh rupees. It is 47,456 favorable. I think there would be no doubt in this question. Now, from part 3, that is part 3 and part 4 is not relevant for CA intermediate new course. But don't take the risk, you must solve it. It's easy, you can just read it and practice, you'll get to know. Okay, I hope this lecture was beneficial to you. Now you can solve question number 3, question number 4. Question number 5, question number 6, no, not 6, till question number 5 you can solve. Yeah, till question number 5. Okay, I hope you got it. Yeah, I was checking for more sums if you can solve. No, but you can also solve question number 15, that page number 11.33, question number 15. Okay, it's an easy sum. You can solve. If you can't solve, then do comment under this video, and rest we'll discuss in the next lectures. It will take up to 1 to 2 lectures more maximum. Okay, I can though able to comp I can complete this chapter in just one lecture, but you have to revise your formulas too. So I'm completing the lecture right now. So thank you everybody, take care, bye bye, and do like and share my videos and channel with your friends for free classes. I'll be giving free classes of tax, and but if you need any a type of special topic of accounts, advanced accounts or costing or FM, you can just comment under any video, I'll reply it, okay? Or you can join my Telegram channel. I'm giving the link of my Telegram channel under this video in the description and the comment box. You can join that. And yes, one more important announcement. I have yesterday on 2nd of Feb 2019, I have started with test series of accounts and tax. Today is the second day of test. I have uploaded it on my Telegram channel and I'll be live today itself at night so that you can get the solution of the test. Okay, now take care, bye bye. Do like, share and subscribe my channel.